Today marks the 16th anniversary of the September 11th terror attacks. The commemoration in New York City began with a moment of silence at tolling bells at 8:46 a.m. when the first terrorist-piloted plane slammed into the World Trade Center's North Tower. The victims' relatives again began reading the names of the nearly 3,000 people killed when four hijacked planes hit the World Trade Center in New York City, the Pentagon, and a Pennsylvania field. Among those who read out names at the solemn ceremony in New York City are a cousin of victims Maria Teresa Santillan and Judy Hazel Fernandez, and the niece of victim Jaceril M. DeChavez. Judy Fernandez was 27 years old and was working as a benefits specialist for Cantor Fitzgerald on the top floor of the World Trade Center. She was the one who helped her cousin, Maria Teresa Santillan, also just 27 years old, get her job at eSpeed as a customer service representative.
And my cousins and dear friends, Judy, Hazel, Santillan, Fernandez, and Maria Teresa Concepcion Santillan, knowing you are together warms my heart every day. We all miss you very much and will forever be in our thoughts and our prayers.
Jaceril DeChavez also worked in the Twin Towers and was only 24 years old.
I never met you, but deep down in my heart, I truly love you. I heard many great stories about you. I always think what life would be with you. If you were here, life would be perfect, but even without you, we love you with all our heart. Mahal na mahal kita.
20 Filipinos were killed in the attacks, including two who were on board United Airlines Flight 193 that crashed near Shanksville, Pennsylvania. Today, President Donald Trump observed a moment of silence at the White House and spoke at a memorial at the Pentagon.
America does not bend. We do not waver. And we will never, ever yield. So here at this memorial, with hearts both sad and determined, we honor every hero who keeps us safe and free. And we pledge to work together, to fight together, and to overcome together every enemy and obstacle that's ever in our path.
Len Amadin Thornhill, ABS-CBN News.